architects, dead butterflies, the ghosts that wish to exist. Definitely does not apply to me. Just running to him one step closer. Some I used to revel in decades ago. Decades ago. Did I feel the same way I do now? To be honest, TBH. Decades have passed by, the noose has gotten tighter and tighter and tighter. I know I'm supposed to be positive. That makes it even harder, I believe. A lot, if not every last thing, you know. Professed, expressed, conveyed by Mr. D.I. Because you know how you should be feeling. You know and believe negative thoughts are going to bring negative impact on your life and negative things your way. I didn't want you more. And do I believe that if there had been no Omar, Joe and I could have worked things out? Yeah, Joe even said as much. Doesn't mean we, you know, we wouldn't still have our problems. Joe essentially said we weren't able to. Because of Omar, we weren't able to deepen our relationship, our friendship, we weren't able to. Like, you can't even go away for the day, whatever, everything's Omar. I've had him since he was that big, I've had him for 14 plus years, you know? No, as I told Miss Selena, Joe didn't tell me. He would never say that. He doesn't have to. He doesn't have to say anything. He can't stand the drama, okay? So he says as much. You know, if there was no Omar, this did whatever, then... The nature of my mom and the nature of Omar, that's just, just like to me the last day of screaming at me to call, to tell him to stop it. Like, you tell me not to yell when I'm not even mad, I'm just loud. If I'm upset about something or excited or whatever, you're screaming at me when I'm inches away from you. not that out of the, because I said when you said, not just last week, that when you made that commitment, it was for good, and even now you're going back on it. I wasn't saying that to change his mind. I was saying that because it is what he said. I think his final straw, and also again, he, I guess I wasn't. I could never be appreciative enough in his eyes, and I didn't know what he wanted. Because just because I am beyond appreciative, I mean, it goes without saying. I said to him, like, you don't understand how shocked I was that you would allow me and that little arm to come and live with you. But that doesn't mean I'm never going to get upset with you. I'm never snap at you if I'm having a really bad day. You do it to me. And just because I don't work doesn't mean I'm not human. Okay? Just because your problems with work always are going to supersede my minutiae, my drama, you know. And he's right, I don't understand. But I can't. If I'm not experiencing firsthand what you are going through at your extremely difficult job where you're not, you know, then it's impossible. If I'm not experiencing that, it's impossible for me to understand. So what he wants from me, I mean, he definitely a jealous woman. He said as much. We'd be having a deep conversation and Omar starts crying and I'm like, I'm sorry, I have to go take care of Omar. But what I can't say to Joe and what Joe has to understand is here, it's not the end of the world if Omar goes to the bathroom in the crate. At Joe's, it pretty much is the end of the world, see? That's the difference. So I don't want to clean it up, but I'm not going to risk Omar going to the bathroom in the crate so you can finish your conversation. I will risk it if we're taking off for hours, or if I'm taking off here, whatever, but I really won't be doing anything. I had to come back, and I thought I'd be coming back knowing that I was gonna go back to Joe's for good. And Joe dropped a bombshell on me. Architects for those that wish to exist. And what about those of us who don't? That's the album I don't hear the song. I don't know what it's like. pretty simple to vow since I was going to Jerusalem, he doesn't have advanced cable that gets me to trust me. But I also removed all my songs from MP3 player and just went back in time. Not all of them, but a lot of them. Yeah, it's definitely worse when you know. I'm a changed person in terms of what I now know and can't unknow. Speaking of which, Foo Fighters came on. I'm used to choice rock and roll. And I just said to her, elaborate. I'm just like, yeah. DG, lead singer sucks. No, I'm sorry, I did elaborate. Anyhow, I'm not watching any, listening to any old songs. Only 2021 songs. Although, something, is it called Circle? I don't know what it's called. Circle of Darkness? Anyway, a song that I probably never heard before because it's only each song is slowly released from the F8 album of 500 Death Punch. Their song keeps playing on the soundtracks. And I heard other songs from that album, so when they release it one at a time, you know, so I didn't ever hear this one. I may have listened to it once when I was trying to determine if I liked any of the songs from the album. I didn't remember it. I returned to 1956. Version of 1984 last Friday. And I plan on ordering the one that I wanted. Which still isn't, it's from the 1980s, I think it was released in 1984. That's what I wanted. Podcast should be coming tomorrow. It's supposed to come today. I was told the wrong thing. Misled me on. Should be coming tomorrow. Hopefully we'll get that when our internet working. My mom's always wanted a computer. Pays for itself anyway because, as I think I told you back when I was a student, I think I told you my mom decided she couldn't do smartphones, she can't stand it. It was making her severely depressed. And I helped her get rid of it because she was afraid to fail, afraid to tell that I, you know, that I told children I had to kill them and get rid of that phone. She's miserable, it's making her miserable. So, a smartphone is safe, 50 months, 60 months, whatever, in between 50 tax, you know. And the little flip phone she has is 25, so computer pays for itself in 3 years. Plus we needed to order food because my days of lugging groceries home from the grocery store, which I never should have really done in the first place because there were times I really pushed myself a whole thing. I'm getting too old for that shit. Ain't happening anymore. So just for that reason alone, you would need a computer. computer is filled with thousands of pictures and videos, and I would never, I'm lugging it back and forth from here to Joe's when I come to visit her. And, you know, it didn't, I thought I was just coming to visit. And again, on the way to the airport, Joe dropped a bombshell. We'd had a bad day the day before. But he didn't exactly drop it on me. I forced it out of him. You know? I would have gone down the day before. Just, it was our last day together. It made me feel like he was just, you know. Not really caring as much about me. He just, I think Joe would just rather be alone. And of course it hurts. Are very different. I've told you that. Personality-wise, Joe and I are so different. The way we are the same is we have the same. We see the world in the same way. We have the same, you know, view. Our core values. But personality-wise, I'm all very, very different. And we grew up very differently. So differently. So when I say to him, you can't scream at me from downstairs to come down there and do something, you trigger me like you wouldn't believe. And then you act like nothing happened. That was ending our friendship, Joe. You're gonna think I'm just staying there for a free place to stay and don't really love you? Yeah, I'll prove it by leaving, but it's not true. That's how we taught. We did that when I was, I don't give a fuck. Don't care. You don't talk to me like that. You don't. So even after we made up, because I laid it on the line with him, there's no way I could just leave and not, you know, pour my heart out. This is my decades-long friend. This isn't some guy I met off the internet, you know. Don't. Packing up and leaving, we just had a bad, bad day. And there's no right or wrong. Like Joe said, he's like, we're always having to explain ourselves to the other person. I know, because we grew up very differently, and I come from an abusive background. So I'm highly sensitive to what I perceive as criticism or someone trying to be controlling. You know? Plus, I know how you feel about messes and this, that, and whatever, so. Yeah. If I'm feeling good about where I'm at in terms of packing and whatnot, and you see a small mess on the floor, and I'm like, oh, and say to me, well, I thought you'd be further along. Are you sure you're gonna be, are you sure you're gonna make the air, make your flight? Doesn't say, well, oh my God, look, I didn't like that. I didn't like that. And I said as much to her. Because I said, yeah, I'll be fine, whatever. Are you sure? You know, they know. And he says that's concern. I think that people can hide being, trying to be controlling and act like it's concern. And I give a perfect example. If you say to someone that, you know, you're looking kind of heavy or you're eating too much or whatever, then they can view that as being controlling. And you can say, well, I'm just concerned. And I said to him, well, even if I have to stay up all night, so what? You know, I'll commute down, whatever. And he said, well, you shouldn't stay up all night. You shouldn't do that if you have to catch a flight. Leave me alone. You won't stay up late or whatever. Sometimes you have to go to work the next day. And it's not your business. And Joe says, you know, you get so defensive. I'm just being concerned for you. And I don't perceive that as concern. I perceive it as you're putting me down or thinking that I'm not going to make my flight. I'm not going to get done what I need to get done. And then Joe's like, well, then we just don't get along, you know. I don't know. Story. I was very hurt because I'm leaving for months and who knows, maybe something will happen and I can't even come back at all. And you're just nonchalant. But it turned out again, he didn't feel well, but didn't tell me. Just like that other fight we had that time where I didn't do anything wrong. And he said they'd already, I didn't feel well. Alright, but you don't feel well and you're in a pissy mood. And then, but you don't tell me you don't feel well. It's like, and it turned out, he told me after the fact, that he believes, and I believe him, because he never wanted over there in the first place, that he didn't feel well because I accidentally, of course, but I think it was probably the first time ever, and Joe does it all the time, but I accidentally didn't clear out the lint, the dryer, which I washed Omar's thing only because Omar's saying that, Joe was saying that it smelled, and then it had, Joe went to open up the lint thing and that dog hair from Omar went in, but you're gonna have dog hair anyway, but if you don't like it or you're semi-allergic, you're gonna be in trouble. I'm always gonna be covered with dog hair. I have to carry Omar all the time, and Joe's not a dog person. He doesn't even understand why people have dogs. He said it to me, he's like, I don't know why people like dogs. So he couldn't have known. He could not have known until actually having us there. And that's when he was screaming at me in the airport. I mean, in the car, and I said, Joe, why are you screaming? I'm simply reiterating to you what you said last week, where I said, you know, you're constantly threatening to throw me out. He's like, yeah, but I don't mean it. He's like, you know, when I agreed to have you guys here, I made a commitment that I wouldn't break it. And I don't want you to do that. I said to him, I don't want you here. You to have us here unless you really want us here. And he basically said he didn't. And then I was crying and I'm like, well, if there was no Omar, do you just can't stand Omar. He's not a dog person, and he's like dog Omar's a pain, and all he does is cry. And he's but he also, my mom does things that have me getting upset over the phone, like frustrated, like the $1,500 toy, for example, that she ordered behind my back, okay? Even if she could afford the monthly payments, but when she told me about it, I didn't even know. Oh, she's like, well, it's $14.95 trial. Yeah, but how much is it regular? She's like, no, she didn't know. She sees the information. So, but Joe's trying to work, and if I get loud on the first floor and he's in the basement, it is. He's had to tell me to be quiet before I get agitated, you know. If you're really not a dog person regarding any dog, and then you have this, Joe's never encountered any dog like going on. It's like, nobody would put up with that dog. And I'm like, well, I'm not putting him to sleep. I'm not asking you to put him to sleep. Yeah, but you're essentially saying that it's, I'm making the choice that to either, you know, it's you or Omar. I'm not gonna make that choice. Even though Joe would call me insane, literally, maybe a lot of you would as well, I have a moral obligation to Omar. Joe says that's a beast that would eat you if you were dead and if he was hungry, starving. I don't wanna hear that either. Even if it is true, even if I know it's true, I don't wanna hear it. Also have a moral obligation to my mother. And Selena's like, well, I'm sure your mom wouldn't hurt Omar, not intentionally. But also, Omar's getting older and older. My mom, to have her be in the position where she'd be crying her eyes out to me. She'd be crying to me over the phone, what do I do about Omar? I can't do that to her. I have had Omar.